Often engineers need to know how the frequency content of a signal changes with time. This is true even of short time duration events like clicks, clunks, and slams. Let's work together to understand how the frequency content changes with time for this transient event. First, what we'll do is go to Tools, Add-ins, and turn on the Time Variant Frequency Analysis add-in. This uses 34 tokens. Next, we'll take our time data and put it in the input basket. We'll go to Time Data Selection, import the data, and turn on a preview. Use the selection tool to highlight one of the transient events in the data. For this demo, I just want to analyze this one burst, not every burst. Click Use Segment for Processing to make sure that only the data highlighted in black is processed. Then go to Time Frequency Analysis and click Make Segment List to import the data. First, let's try using an FFT to understand how the frequency content changes with time. Make sure that Short Time Fourier Transform is selected here, and then click Calculate Selected to populate the display. Often, even in a short duration time event, there are multiple events going on that compose the transient. Engineers typically want to see each of these components decomposed by time and frequency. Take a look at the time data. You can see that the frequency content changes with time. It comes in, goes out, and goes through changes even within one short burst. The Fourier transform doesn't track this very well. There's not a lot of resolution in time or in frequency. Let's try using the wavelet as an alternative. Go to Processing and drop down to the wavelet transform. Then click Calculate Selected again and compare the wavelet result to the FFT. Notice that the wavelet method provides more detailed information about what frequency content is present at various times. The FFT result is quite smeared in both time and frequency. Wavelet analysis provides finer resolution in the time domain compared to FFT methods. Check out the article for details on why that is. When performing wavelet analysis, there are a few parameters to be aware of. The bandwidth is automatically determined as half the sampling frequency of the data being processed. The minimum and maximum frequencies will determine the limits of the wavelet analysis. The wavelets per octave field will affect the resolution of your wavelet map. More wavelets per octave will give a finer resolution, but also increase the file size. Play around with this setting to find the ideal parameter for your analysis. The Time Frequency Analysis workbook is a great place to play around with wavelet settings. But if you want to do batch processing of wavelets, you may want to try the Time Data Processing workbook. Go to Tools, Add-ins, and turn on Signature Throughput Processing. Under the section settings, you can scroll to find the Wavelet Maps option, and you'll see the same parameters that you were playing with in the Time Frequency Analysis workbook. Here is a great place to batch process wavelet maps. Enjoy the increased insight that wavelet maps offer when analyzing transients.